Hi, my name is John Hoimy. I'm the owner of Alternative Health, and I'd like to tell you my story as far as it goes to wellness. In 1989, I retired from the United States Air Force, and I thought I was pretty healthy. I got out, started doing some civilian work, and I went through quite a bit of stress, and all of a sudden I noticed that my health was starting to deteriorate. Went on for quite some time, and of course things just migrated and got worse, and I started gaining weight and didn't think a whole lot about it because I was busy and had a family and was doing the things that we all do. And in about 1995, 96, I started going to doctors regularly, they put me on a lot of medications. I really couldn't understand what was happening. Doctors told me, you're getting older, you're under stress, that's the way life goes. And quite frankly, I just said, well, I guess that's the way life is. And every time I would go to the doctor, I would get a new medication, I would get something different, and I would think, okay, this has got to be the answer. By about 1997, 98, I started developing panic attacks. And the panic attacks became so severe that I just could not tolerate it. In fact, I started passing out. They would put me in an ambulance, haul me into the hospital. They would put me on oxygen overnight. Next day, put me on a treadmill and tell me, you're fine, you're healthy. And I kept asking, why then am I passing out from anxiety? And they said, well, you know, we're not quite sure. And, you know, you just need to take care of yourself or you need to take more medications. So they put me on some antidepressants. And they said, this will probably help. Well, it didn't help. More trips to the hospital, more stress tests, more treadmills, etc. Finally, one day, I was in the doctor's office, and I was sitting in my little gurney robe sitting there, and the doctor came in and said, you know, nothing is working. Your blood pressure is out of sight. Your cholesterol is way too high. Your triglycerides are just unbelievable. And they said, there's really nothing we can do for you, and I'm afraid that you're going to be face down the pavement. That really shocked me. And I said, why? Well, you're older. And I said, I'm 49. And I quite frankly said, if this is what old is about, I don't want to be in my 50s, 60s, 70s. And he said, well, I think we need to increase your antidepressants, and we need to put you on some anxiety medication, which was dazepramine and some other things. I can't even remember the names of anymore. And I got done, I walked out of the office, and I said, that's it, no more. I'm going to quit taking all my medications. And I went home, I flushed them down the toilet, said, if I'm going to die, I'm just going to do it this way and be done. My sister, who I call my Irish twin, she's only 11 months younger than me, she freaked out. She said, you can't stop taking your meds. I said, well, I did, unless we're going to go down the toilet, we're not getting them. And she said, oh no, you have to take them. And I told her, that's my business, and that's it. She said, okay, do me a favor, I want you to meet a woman, this doctor that I know from back in Minnesota, North Dakota area I met, and I want you to go see her. And I said, absolutely not. I said, no more doctors, I'm done. She said, well, this doctor is different. I said, they've all been different, okay, so don't bother me, let it go. Nope, she says, you've got to go see her, I'm not going to let this happen. So she bought a plane ticket, open-ended, and she said, Dr. Nelson is going to be in Chicago, and I want you to go see her. Now, this is pre-9/11, so you could get a ticket and hold it and all that stuff. So I thought about it, and she bugged me unmercifully as the date came that Dr. Nelson was going to be in Chicago. So I thought, well, I'll go to Chicago. I'll spend your dime and visit Chicago for a few days and come back. So I went to Chicago. I met Dr. Nelson, and she was doing some training or seminars or whatever it was. And I met with her. And we did a consultation, and in about 10 minutes she said, you have candida. I said, what in the world is candida? I'd never heard of such a thing. Now, I will tell you, I'm going to age myself here, that when I was a kid, there was a song called O Candida. And it was done by Tony Orlando and Don, and that's all I could think of. So I said to her, I said, is that what that song was about when I was a kid? And I remember she looked at me with a serious look and said, I don't know. And I said, okay. I said, what's Candida? She said, well, it's an over infestation of yeast in the body. And she said, you know, it's primarily a female thing. I thought, dear God, who is this person? Are you kidding me? I thought, I need to run out of here. Not walk, I need to run. She said, but men have it too. You know, you can get rid of it. There's things you have to do. And I said, okay, what do I have to do? And she laid it out in general terms. I said, I'm not doing that, I'm too busy. Now remember, I thought I was dying and a doctor said I was gonna be face down, but that didn't matter at that time. I said, I'm not doing that. She looked at me with a very stern look and she said, when you're sick enough, you will. Or she says, you're gonna die a premature death, or worse yet, you'll be debilitated and somebody have to take care of you the rest of your life. I thought, well, that's kind of rude. So I said, all right, you know, I'll think about it. And the day went on, I listened to some more things that she had to say in her training seminar. And I came back at one of the breaks and I said, you know what, I'm gonna try it. She says, you don't try it. You either do it or you don't. And if you're not gonna do it, don't waste your time, don't waste your money, and don't waste my time. I thought, wow. So I said, you know what, I'm gonna do it. Now being retired military, I'm pretty much cut and dried. I'm just going to do it. I'm going to prove to my sister, my daughter, and to this Dr. Nelson that, you know what, it's not going to work. So we packed up all the stuff. I went back to the East Coast, and I started the program. And I will never forget that on day 10, I slept all night. The first time in years I slept all night. I woke up in the morning, and it was dark. And I thought, what time, where am I? And I realized I had slept. I went to work and I told some people, I said, wow, I feel great. I slept all night last night. People looked at me like, really? I mean, so what do you normally do? I said, I normally don't sleep, but I slept all night. And I was like a kid in a candy store, and I couldn't wait to go home that night, go to bed, and see if I'd sleep again. And lo and behold, I slept. And I remember my body taking some changes and doing things, and you know, and I found out in wellness a lot of things to kind of hinge on elimination. I remember calling Dr. Nelson and saying, I don't know how to ask you this, but I'm eliminating stools and they're all weird colors, greens, and she said, that's putrefied fecal matter coming out of your body, no problem. I'm thinking, are you kidding me? But I was feeling better. I was doing well, I had energy, my patience was increasing. I was like, wow, this is great. Well, finally, after about 6 weeks, I remember calling her and I said to her, you know what, I have two complaints. And she said, what's that? Number one, why didn't my doctor do this for me a long time ago? She said, well, that's a conversation with the pharmaceutical industry and it's a different subject for a different time. What's your second complaint? I said, why don't you have facilities around here to help people? I said, I can't be the only person that has this problem. She says, you're correct. She said, but you know what? It's different, it's difficult, and it takes the right type of person that wants to help people get well. And she said, if you're looking maybe for a career change at some point, you want to help people like I've helped you, we'll work together. So I talked to my sister and I said, hey, look, I think I want to do something different. I want to get out of the business I was in, which was a furniture business. I want to go in and help people. And so we started a company called Alternative Health. And that was in 1990. And that was in the year 2000. And we opened up our business and we started helping people. And at first I was kind of like on the program, I thought, how many people are really going to say, you know what, I'm going to do the things you did, etc. But it was worth a shot. So I ran an ad, and this was actually while I still had my furniture business, and I ran an ad for fibromyalgia. And it said, are you sick and tired of being sick and tired? I ran a small ad, and all of a sudden the phone started ringing. People said, I got fibromyalgia. I barely knew what it was myself. And I'm, can I come in and talk to you? My wife has got it. And I'm like, holy smokes, this is insane. So I started working with people, with Dr. Nelson virtually over my shoulder, guiding me. And I was on the phone with her all the time, asking her questions and trying to help people. And all of a sudden, people said, I feel better. I remember one of my first clients, a gentleman came in. He was a Frenchman. And he came in and gave me this huge hug. He says, my wife can get in and out of the car. She can do things she hasn't done for years. It's phenomenal. And all of a sudden I realized, wow, I'm helping people. And then I started to progress and I opened up a bigger place and we started talking to people. And people started coming in and getting well. And then all of a sudden they started referring people. And people would come in and say, I know what you did for so-and-so and I want that. And I'd tell them, well, I don't know that you need that. Well, I don't care what I need, I want that. And I thought, there are so many people that need help. So then I started to expand and I started to really study and learn and work hard on my profession. And I opened up two more locations. So I have three locations where I'm working with people and keeping myself busy at a pace of almost insanity sometimes. And people just say, you know, I don't understand why this, nobody else ever told me about this. And I've taken people with, a gentleman came in years ago, and he walked in, he looked at me, and he said, can you help me? And I said, what's your problem? He said, they want to cut my colon out next week. Really, why? I have ulcerative colitis. I said, okay, geez, I don't know about, you know, telling him don't have your colon cut out. So I get on the phone with Dr. Nelson, we do a three-way conversation. She says, before you do anything, let's get your immune system stronger. So we put him on a wellness program. 11 years later, 12 years later, he still has a colon. He's as healthy as could be. I had a lady that had a frozen shoulder. She said, they want to do surgery on my shoulder. I said, you know what? Let's put you on a program and then get your immune system strong so that when you do go in and have surgery, you'll heal faster. I said, you know, frozen shoulders probably not going to change doing a program. So she did a 60-day candida program. I walked in to meet her, as I meet everybody when they're all done with the program. She said, John, guess what? I said, what's that? I went to the doctor. They don't need to do surgery. My shoulder's free. I couldn't believe it. I was shocked. He said, the doctor doesn't understand what happened or why it happened. I said, well, good things happen when we get our body healthy. I said, but stay healthy. And I could go on and on and on with the hundreds of people that I've worked with that have written testimonials. And I always encourage people to go on my website and look at the website and say, read some of the letters that people have done. And it actually gives me goosebumps when I talk to people and they tell me, you know what? You saved my life. And I've had so many people tell me that. You saved my life. Or a young girl sitting in my office one day after her mother finished the program said, you know what? My mother is a different person. We go shopping now. Before, I couldn't even be around her. It was too hard, or she didn't want to leave the house. And now we just have so much fun. And that's coming from a 10, 11-year-old girl. That is impactful. And there are times I get goosebumps and I almost get tears thinking about the things that I've done to help people. Not that I can do it. I've just been trained, I've been taught, and through the will of God, just been given the tools to say, you know what? If somebody really wants to get well, there are tools, there are ways to do it and take care of yourself and heal your body and live the kind of life that we're supposed to live on this earth. That's my story. And I love doing what I do and I'm passionate. And I tell you, when I work with my people, I'm strict. I tell them what they need to do. And you have two choices. Like Dr. Nelson told me, either do it or don't. It's your choice. And that's what I tell everybody. And I will tell the world that. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.